Hello friends, this is Mansoor Hossain from IT Markaz Technologies. Today I am going to show you how you can configure or read or in your Linux box. For this I am using VMware for my lab. Let me power out this gas. Suspend. Okay. Right now I have I already have a setup of CentOS 6.5. I have added three additional drives for my read purpose or read tutorial. I have powered on. The next thing which I need to perform is first I need to log into the system. Okay, next thing I need to verify that how many drives are connected with my Linux box. For this purpose I am using the command /dev/pipesinegrab sd. So it will show me all the drives which are connected to my box. Before begin with the read configuration, I need to partition all the disks which I want to add into the read array. In our case, we are using fdisk sdb, sdbc, sdbd. So I'm just partitioning these drives /dev/sdb. N for new partition, P for primary partition, 1 for the number of the partition, and it's a first cylinder, last cylinder, and W for the save the configuration. I will do the same for the rest of the two drives. Make sure you have the same partition number for this particular type of read configuration. You can have the different partition number, but because we are using the different methodology, so I would recommend to have a same partition number, but similarly you can have the different partition number as well. Okay, I have partitioned the disk. Now I need to install the utility which will be going to use for as a software read, yum install mdadm. This is the utility which we will be using for it is already have been installed on my box. The next thing which I need to perform is to need to check the existing configuration on the drives which I am going to add into the array. For this I am going to use the mdadm command with capital minus E and the drives sd btd and partition number. Okay, as you can see that I haven't found any super blocks on my drives. Now next thing I need to create a the next thing I need to verify that do I have any kind of read configuration. So I can see that I have MBR partitioning or super block on these devices. And the another next thing which I need to perform is I need to create a array using mdadm --create --level. minus minus create slash dev slash md0 space minus minus level is equal to 5 and minus minus read device minus minus read devices equal to 3. Then I have to list all the devices: dev sd b1, dev sdc1, dev sdd1. Now it will create the array. After this I need to check the status of the array, so I will use this command. It is showing that read is creating. Before I have to wait for until this synchronization process has been complete. This will take a while. Meanwhile, I'm stopping the video. When it will be done, I will be back. As you can see that it is done now. Now I can verify the status. The all blocks have been saved. The next thing, I need to create a partition for the RAID drive which I added earlier. ext4 slash dev slash md0. Now my RAID disk is ready. Now the next thing or the last thing is I need to create a directory where I can mount it. I am creating directory as a RAID. Now I need to mount space minus t ext4 slash dev md0 slash RAID. Okay, now if I see, so I can see the partition of 40 gig is available for use. Before we move further, we should check the last configuration